And this is coming down, I'm guessing. Nope, nope, it's going up. Of course, the cavalier leaves. It's already 100%, so this stuff's already happening. It's actually coming under reasonable control. Why have I got 5 here? Well, that thing should be reassigning now. Hmm? What's that? Yeah, that's a good list to get from. Get more military factories up as well. Seems the new empire is going to rise. Not going to be easily. That'd be too easy. We've got the Mongol Empire over here. It's like the new Mongol Empire. Dude, well, the axis, that's... what's it look like in faction map mode, anyway? Yeah, most of the world's taken aside. I wonder which side they're going to take, that's the question. I think you much better just have a choice. Are you over 50% yet? 50%? They're starting to get issues, though. I mean, those revolutionaries, you know, not kindest people in the world, are they? Actually, we've got bombers down here, haven't we? Yeah, we can leave the Black Sea now. Let's move you guys over to... it's too small. Guyana. There's going to be a ton of these. We're not going to be able to just move over because there's not enough space. We'll just leave them over there for now. They're at least doing something. They're feeling useful, even if they're not useful. Legionnaires... Now, why are they called Legionnaires Bulgaria anyway? Hmm. It's a question that might never be answered. Oh well. This is what I mean by I wish there's more random events, by the way. It's so quiet and dull when there's nothing going on. I mean, like, you know, I'm sitting here thinking, you know, I wish something would happen. And it's not. It's actually kind of sad when you think about it. Alright. Oh, yeah, you're actually getting over. Sweet. That's a good sign. Just look at the hill! Oh, they're still waiting over here. Nope, Operation Conga Line happened. Okay, whenever I say Operation Conga Line, it's like literally like this. Where you get like a long stream of troops just walking after each other. Or in this case, railing after each other. There's... a reason for it, I get that, is like the pathfinding and blah 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 blah. But still, it looks kind of ridiculous when you look at it. 11 days until we get the field hospital. I'm going to put this in units, it's going to be too useful not to. our marines are moving up. Can I actually get you assigned to a group yet? Yes, I can. That's good. I want you guys to assign to this group. Because this is going to be the big thing now. Because we are going to just push straight up through the American, through the South American side of things. And I don't want to give them linear leeway. How can I assign you to that automatically then? I'll have to give you like a fallback thing or something. Alright, let's look at production again. What else can we get? Let's actually make a group that is heavy tanks. Duplicate. Let's go for. Now we've got all Italian, that's heavy tanks. We'll back it up with. We'll go lights up with anti-air. And we'll go with some mechanized to make it the center. Can't really do anything there. But we'll go with some more armor of a heavy tank gate again with some self-powered anti-air. And this is Heavy Panzer Division. It doesn't really matter how you assign them, by the way. You can do it like with the infantry left or right. This is really just for your aesthetical appearance, that kind of thing. Topmost just decides what you can put in, though. That's the one thing that matters. The more combat battalions you have, the bigger your combat width, and the fewer these divisions are able to fit in the battle. Basically, don't go too wide. Simple as. Let's go with logistics company. I need to start putting these around the groups as well. So, you to give you logistics company, because this is going to save us on supply. You've got two things you can put in, apparently. Oh, no, you don't. There's our field hospital. So let's get that put in as well. Let's take out... support anti-air. So I don't think we're going to need that, to be fair. I'd rather keep my casualties and experience lost down. Don't have you. Don't have you. We have the Marines who do need it. We're not going to give them logistics company. We'll give them support anti-air and support anti-tank. I could really stand to make this a bit bigger, to be fair. Yeah, let's throw a few more in here. And the mechanized will throw in the logistics. Take out support anti-air because we've got an light self-propelled anti-air at the back. Okay, a field hospital. And what's the other one we use? We've got heavy panzers. That got the stuff? Take out support anti-air for field hospital because you've got the light self-propelled. And since we've got research done, let's actually work on medium self-propelled stuff. Or alternatively, it's 1943. We could work on the Panther and the Königstiger. Or the Mouse. Let's get the Panther. Panther is a common name of the medium tank deployed by Germany in World War II, from mid-1943 to the end of the European War in 1945. It was intended as a counter to the Russian T-34, and as a replacement for the Panzer III and IV. While never replacing the latter, it was served alongside it in the heavier Tiger tanks till the end of the war. Panther's excellent combination of firepower, mobility, and protection served as a benchmark for the other nations' late war and post-war tank designs, and is regarded as one of the best tanks of World War II. The Allies kept a factory open after World War II, just building Panthers for 6 months or so. Just so they could test their weapons against it. Which probably goes to show you just how big the Panther was to the Allies. How big a threat it was, how much they needed to work to counter it, that kind of thing. Like, there's a lot of, like I keep saying, there's a lot of interesting history to do with World War II. And that is one I didn't know of until recently, so yeah, bear that one in mind. Alright, Columbia. I feel so sorry about this, but we need your... Okay, I'm gonna get shot if I say that. Yep. I'm sorry, my friend. We can invite Venezuela to faction. Sweet. So, wait, what's that do for us, anyway? Okay, we need to stop boosting... Yep, in here. Peru, are you coming towards us, or are you going against us? Why can't I invite you to faction? Opinion isn't helping. World tension. Peru hostile towards Colombia. We have a war that we're drawn into. Let's guarantee your independence. That help? Alright, we can't signal boost there anymore, but we can signal boost here. I know it's not signal boosting, but let's call it signal boosting just because it is. We are signal boosting there. I'll be signal boosting here. We're signal boosting here. I wouldn't be surprised if the DVOS is happening. US influence, yeah. So we need to be careful. Because the US is busy down here. Technically speaking, we shouldn't be able to win here. Oh, but that's wars been merged. Don't worry, this doesn't get me hard at all. Just push up to here. Just go. They don't have an army that can beat us anytime soon. Panama. You're not coming to us anytime soon, are you? It's gotta be easiest to justify war goals and plow through them all. Costa Rica. Nicaragua. If I do this right, I think I can actually chain them all together and just conquer them all in a row. Instead of doing it the slow way, you know, we just wait one at a time. Oh, what's this? This is Mexico, ooh. Yeah, you know what? It ain't gonna help you. Yes, just go. Guys? Hello? It'd be nice if you could, I don't know, do the plan. This guy's like 233 divisions, of course. Research, okay. So let's actually get the, that's a good question. What do I want? Probably advanced artillery. It's not bad. I actually like it a ton. So these guys are probably not really going to get into combat anytime soon. Then again, where are you guys? You're sailing over. That's actually not bad. We've got tons of German troops just redeploying to get ready. What's this? Venezuela wants to join our war. Feel free. I'm not going to stop you. I mean, this won't take long at all. You know, are we at the border now, or...? You know, you could be more helpful, game. You just go already? Jeez. There's literally nothing stopping you. Meanwhile, there's a lot stopping you. We call it the Brits. And God, that looks like a hodgepodge. It's like a mess. I know we're on very low supply here, and that's because we just got tons of things going through. We've got 73% attrition. Yeah. We're pushing in. I ain't waiting around. If they ever get into friggin' combat, jeez. This is why you don't fight a war in South America. Or at least a war using tanks. Select half of these guys. Engage this. Are we actually getting the air support over here? Well, allegedly we are. Allegedly. Oh, right, yeah, I could use some groups over here, couldn't we? But no airfields, because they feel like being like that. Meh, meh, meh. Gits. We're gonna have trouble down here, aren't we? This is where we start losing ground, I know it. Because we just haven't got the room to do anything. Guderian's actually really good, jeez. Rank 7. It's got just about everything we need. He's on his way to rank 8. I'm breaking the border. Are you all engaging that? Please don't all be engaging that. Oh, he's 63 reserves only. Christ. You guys engage down here. That's not any much better. That's not any much better. Why is there a cavalry division down here? Sweden. Sphere Reich wants to serve. Okay. Will you be willing to join our faction? They will not accept. It's neutrality, major nation. Huh. They're fascist now. That's actually a really nice name. And Greater Finland. So we got them to flip, sweet. Should really have said yes, to be fair. How are... there they are. Oh, right, because you were in the same team for a time. Join this theatre. It's going to be a lot easier to control it that way. And our resistance is... looking nice, actually. It's mostly under control. So we shouldn't need that many more cavaliers. And if we do, then we're stuffed. I mean, if it's contained down to this... and the British Raj, then that's... not a big thing. So this Prue wants to send a division. Sure. Would you join that war? No, because... opinion... world tension, hostile... most of the war. Let's improve relations anyway, shall we? See if that helps us all. What do we have? 1.29. Sferaik, Estonia, Portugal, Ireland. How the hell are you not... jeez. Fianna, you're good at what you do, but jeez, join us. You're much better off. Ah, well, that makes sense. Jeez. What about you? You're getting close. You're like halfway there. On the edge. What am I doing? Venezuela's in the war. You. Because we can expand this front line. Or not. That's better. I just push straight through to here. And just go. I don't really care anymore. I just want you guys to win. How are the Allied battle plans looking anyway? It's not too bad, actually. We're getting all our reinforcements. This is going to be fun when we start the invasion. When we start the invasion of America. So once we get Miami, we'll just split everything off. What's getting a fleet over here? Do we still have that fleet down here, by the way? Yes, we do. Right, hold position. Let's go to here. I want you to get repaired now. Once you get over there, we'll work on what you do. How are our dry docks looking? We can cut down the convoys now that everything's over there. I mean, we've got what, 450 of them? Jeez. Alright, we're definitely cutting that down. And yeah, cut you about there. Just gonna keep the two up just in case we need them. Not making more subs. Alright, so we can move on a couple hundred places. This is gonna hurt if it goes wrong. But it's gonna be funny. There we go. Panama join the Allies.